ladies and gentlemen. He's a child of God, a husband, NRA conservative, radical right-wing supervillain, and Twitter rock star. American by birth, Texan by choice, and a badass by nature. He's the owner of TomOHalloran.com, OHalloranMedia.com, and PatriotRadio.net. Please welcome Tom O'Halloran.
There ain't no doubt I love this land. God bless the U.S.
And we are back. Good morning, America. This is the Patriot Radio Show. I being your host, Tom O'Halloran. And I'm broadcasting today from an underground bunker deep in Arcantana, Brascarado. We've got a great show for you today. We're going to be joined, as we are always joined, post-primary days, by our good friend Ken Crow. Be on the phone in just a minute. We can talk about what happened yesterday, where we go from here, the insanity that will continue for the next few months. Again, my name is Tom O'Halloran. My primary blog being TomOHalloran.com, which was, by the way, down for a little bit this morning. I wasn't sure I was going to have it back up in time for the show. You can find us on Facebook, facebook.com/Patriot Radio Show. Personally, I'm at facebook.com/O'Halloran. And I'm on the air 5 days a week, so tune in every Monday through Thursday, 9 a.m. Texas time for this, the Patriot Radio Show. On Fridays, same time, I do Jihad on America, where I cover the Islamists in America, telling you who they are, what they want, and why you should be afraid. If you did not catch my show on the Muslim Brotherhood, my show Islam is Not a Religion, or my show on Islamophobia, then please find your way to PatriotRadioShow.com and catch all three of these shows. They will give you insight and perspective on the Islamic issue. Perspective that you've probably not heard anywhere else. You'll also gain a solid foundation upon which we build each and every Friday as we continue to pull back the mask of Islam, looking at what's being done in the name of Allah, both here and abroad. And I do the news about Islam around the world because it's a glimpse into the future. Future of what's in store for us here in America if we continue to allow the cancer of Islam to spread here in the homeland. Keep abreast of my shows, listen to the live stream, as well as catch up on any of the archived shows that you may have missed, all at PatriotRadioShow.com. You can also hear the show as it's rebroadcast daily on the ConservativeRadioNetwork.com. You can also find us on your iPhone or Android. Just go to the App Store, download the Spreaker podcast app or the TuneIn app, and you'll have all 300 of our shows at your fingertips. With that, we're going to go straight to the phones, bring in Ken Crow. Ken, are you with me?
Yes, sir. Good morning, my friend. How are you today?
Man, I'm so glad to be doing a show today. I got up and about 7 o'clock, I tried to bring the site up, and nothing. I mean, absolutely nothing. Couldn't be found. So I logged in, I rebooted it, managed to get that done, and never came up. So I spent about 45 minutes on the phone with HostGator, and they managed to get it up just in the nick of time. So anyway, what a night last night. Good grief.
It's a great night if you're a Trump fan.
Yep.
If you're not a Trump fan, it's rather demoralizing. You know, the sad truth is, Ohio went to Kasich only because the Democrats voted up there for Kasich.
Oh, they crossed
tried
over.
Tried to split the thing to make sure that he won Ohio, so he stayed in to hopefully stop Trump.
Ah.
And that's what this is all about. Just to give you some insight into what's really going on, and this is important, guys. You all need to see this. I don't know if you ever watched Showtime, and I'm not a huge Showtime watcher myself. In fact, I never watch it. I wasn't even aware that there was a series on Showtime called The Circus.
Yeah.
And what The Circus is all about, as you apparently know, is politics. Well, they recently did an interview that's on The Circus. And I put the clip up this morning, and what it was apparently Mark Halperin is the narrator for the show or the host or something. And he managed to get in with a dinner group at a really fancy upscale Washington eatery,
right,
steakhouse or whatever. And there was a table of these guys, about 8 or 10 of these guys around the table. You know, we often hear the term GOP establishment, but who is the establishment? Who are these guys? They're almost mythical, like the Bilderberger group, you know.
Right.
Who's really in the Bilderberger group?
The real,
we hear about them, but
the real power,
to know
real power
who
brokers.
They are.
Yeah.
Right. Nobody seems to know who they are, right? Well, I mean, they know a couple of them, but not too many. There's only a few.
Yeah.
So, the bottom line is, the power brokers in Washington are the guys that determine who, what, when, where, anything to do with the GOP. They're the ones that decide. Well, it turns out, we found out who the power brokers are. They actually went on camera. And they were having this dinner thing, and they were discussing how to stop Trump.
Yeah.
This is on video, dude. The article today is called, Here's Your Proof, America. It's literally us against them. You can find it in the breaking news column at crowsnestpolitics.com. There is also a video in there of Jan Morgan, which I'll get to in a minute, and why I put the video in there. But here's the deal. These guys are ex-U.S. congressmen. They are, if you're Karl Rove and you want Jeb Bush to run for president, you go to this group and you tell them, okay, Jeb, you guys all like Jeb, right? Yeah, we like Jeb, no problem. Okay, Jeb's decided he's going to run. We need $100 million put in a PAC so we can run him. And they go, okay, no problem. And a couple of weeks later, you have $100 million in your super PAC for Jeb Bush.
Yeah.
That's who these guys are, okay? They can raise unlimited amounts of money. They can change the rules, which this, I'll get into this in a minute because this is getting ready to happen. I want to stop everything for a minute and digress to last night. Did you happen to hear Kasich's speech last night?
Yeah.
Did you happen to notice what he talked about between drinks? What Kasich is in effect doing, he is the arm. He's the last remaining arm of these power brokers. And he's going to stay in. They're going to ensure he's got enough money. Remember when he kind of laughed and said, people say I'm out of money. And he kind of chuckled and said, nah, I'll have plenty of money.
Yes.
Well, guess where it's coming from? They're going to make sure he's got plenty of money to peel off enough votes. They don't want to do the ultimate, but they're prepared to do the ultimate. They want to force this to a broker or a contested convention, whatever you want to call it. If they can keep Trump from getting the 1,237 votes, then great. But if they can't, no problem. because what they're going to do, it turns out they're having a rules committee meeting a week to 2 weeks before the convention. This is where they go in and establish the rules of the convention. And it turns out that it's these people that meet. And if they don't get what they want with Trump not having a 1237, they're simply going to change the rules where when Trump gets there, sorry, pal, you don't have enough. You're going to have to go. We're going to have to do this broker convention.
Yeah, you don't have.
And that's when they're going to cram Kasich down our throat.
You don't have the requisite 1317. They just move the cheese is what they're going to do.
Well, whatever they're going to do, yeah. You know, either they're not bound delegates, they can flee on the first vote, something.
Yeah,
they're going to do something to upset this apple cart and ensure that Kasich is the nominee. You can take that to the bank.
Well,
now, I won't even talk about what happens if that happens.
Yeah, right.
But they talked about this last night on this video that's in this article I did today. They alluded to it. Apparently, this was shot, I don't know, maybe a week ago or something.
Yes, I watched it online, or I don't know if I saw the clip you saw, but I saw them sitting around a table. One of them said, "This isn't communist Russia. We can't just tell somebody they can't run." And another one says, "Yeah."
Right.
Another one says, "Yeah, and we hate that."
I saw that's the clip that's in my article.
Is it okay? But what a mess!
It's a little over 3 minutes long, but it's extremely revealing because they say Trump isn't eloquent enough. Trump isn't well-spoken enough. He doesn't have he's not highly educated. He's not emblematic of the Republican Party. You know, and the whole thing, you're sitting there cringing, going, my God, these guys are arrogant.
Yeah.
And they are. And when you watch this video, you're going to figure out really quickly what this is all about. So you go back to Kasich last night. Kasich is being propped up. They told him early on, behave yourself, let everybody kill themselves off. You'll be in there close to the end, and then we'll ensure that you get the nomination.
Yeah.
And that's exactly what they're getting ready to try to do. I told you the other day, they're willing to blow the party up.
Yep.
They are willing to blow this election up to save the hold and the stranglehold that they have on the Republican Party and all of the gravy benefits that go with that. And that's exactly what's going on. We are witnessing a revolution. And the people are rising up, and the old guard's going, no, you don't. And they're going, yes, we are. And I'm afraid that if this continues, if somebody doesn't acquiesce, and it needs to be the old guard against the... needs to be the old guard needs to back down.
Yeah.
Because if they don't, you're going to have a full scale, and it's going to get ugly really quickly.
Well,
but I listed in this article, you know, the Ted Cruz people are running around, all of the Ted Cruz people are running around saying, we need a constitutional patriot. We need somebody that will... you know, to be emblematic of, you know, Tea Party values, blah, blah, blah. We found out the other day, Ted Cruz is none of that. When Ted Cruz stood up and sided with Bernie Sanders and sided with Hillary Clinton against Donald Trump, took the side of the protesters who were criminal in nature.
Right.
They weren't protesters. These guys are professionally paid
agitators
to do what they did.
Yeah.
Exactly. They were sent there to disrupt this event and make sure this event did not happen. And he took the side trying to get himself a little bit of political footing so he can say, see, Trump's bad. Trump's bad.
Yeah.
Trump didn't have anything to do with that. It was George Soros. And Ted Cruz proved his allegiance when he did that. And it is not to the First Amendment. It was not to free speech. You know, Trump rented that facility. That was his private event.
Exactly.
For his people. People that wanted to support him could come hear what he had to say. And he had every right to throw them out. But we never got that far. He canceled the event because there were simply too many of them.
Yeah.
And they knew what would happen.
And they were.
And it would get really ugly.
Yeah, it was a very hostile group. So,
for Ted Cruz to do that told me volumes about Ted Cruz. He is not what he's purporting himself to be.
Yep.
He is a religious hypocrite. He's a liar. And he is nothing that he claims to be.
Charlie Cook in the chat room says, Ted would sell his mother to be the president. I agree.
He probably would.
Paul Ryan announced last night, or suggested last night, that he may reach for president during the brokered convention. And Boehner came out and endorsed him. So it's not good.
Much of an endorsement.
Right. It's not going to be hands down Kasich, though.
Well, yeah, I think it probably would be. I think that's just a diversionary tactic. But honestly, if they pull this stunt, Tom, it's going to be literally the unraveling. You know, in my new book coming out here in about 60 days, Ego in a Teabag, there, chapter 18, about half of chapter 18 is an explanation on what it is we need to do as a Tea Party and as a conservative grassroots. And there's an entire outline in there that was crafted by a federal judge by the name of Reed Chambers out of Missouri. He's a retired justice. And not Supreme Court, just, you know, but one of those really high-level judges.
Yeah.
And he crafted the entire thing about how we go about establishing delegates, how we go about getting state chairs, and the whole bit. Now, it's not to form an actual third party. What it is to form a very, very powerful pressure group that the Republican Party basically has to come get the blessing of, because they're so powerful that they shut the Republican Party down. But we're all on the same page. We unify, and we're all speaking as one voice through a process that's similar to what the Republicans do to nominate somebody, only we're doing conservative Tea Party candidates.
Yeah.
And we can get them elected, or we can throw the election, either way, because there's 50 million of us. And it's all laid out in the book on how exactly to do this. And I'm hoping that when I'm on Megyn Kelly and I'm doing these various shows, I'm hoping that this catches the attention of a really, really wealthy gentleman that agrees, that's willing to put up the money to actually seed fund this whole process, because it would stop this Donald Trump thing from ever happening again, because the Republicans would be powerless. There's nothing they'd be able to do.
It'd be nice to see that happen. Brother, stick around. I've got to go pay some bills.
You bet.
Folks, this is the Wednesday morning edition of the Patriot Radio Show. We're on air with Dr. Ken Crow, political guru extraordinaire. Stick around. We'll be right back.
Girls, I know the one place where you are guaranteed to find a great guy. You know, the kind of guy that carries you off on horseback and flies you to Paris and likes to talk about his feelings. He's at the movies. Well, in the movies. Where else will you find a funny architect with airbrushed abs? Girls are lining up for guys like this, but not you, because you bought your tickets ahead on Fandango. So adios, long lines, and hello, handsome astronaut, brain surgeon, spy.
Make a date with Fandango, your ticket to the movies. Family night at the movies is a tradition. It really bonds us together. I love you guys so much. Especially this one. I mean, of course, there's all the, his popcorn's bigger than mine, and she's hitting me. Fandango makes it all so easy with tickets in advance. Honey, you enjoy the chick flick? Kids, you enjoy the animated movie? Daddy's gonna go watch things go boom. That's how we do family movie night.
Bring your family closer together with Fandango, your ticket to the movies.
Boost Mobile believes you deserve more choice.
You can pick your phone,
pick your plan,
and
you can even pick a new spokesperson
and a sell that phone.
The Samsung Galaxy S5 will rock your face off.
Give it to me through tears.
Get unlimited talk, text, and data. Starting at $40 a month.
Wow.
Pick your phone,
pick your plan,
and pick your next spokesperson at BoostMobile.com.
Visit Boost Mobile through the RER Marketplace.
Patriots, have you ever wondered why Google, Yahoo, AT&T, Comcast, and so many others offer free email? Who offers free stuff these days? They do it so that millions will sign up with them. Then as these people send what they think are private emails, the emails get scanned and tagged according to the content of the emails. These companies then sell your email addresses to companies that are selling things that you may be interested in based upon the content of your emails. If you're a veteran or if you have a vet in your family, go to usvetmail.net. Get an email address, your name at usvetmail.net. It's not only private, but it shows pride in your veteran or your pride of service. We never scan our clients' mail, and we never, ever sell or share your information with anyone. Thank you.
I reckon the storms are brewing. Reckon so.
Reckon you got a hotel?
Reckon no. Money's tight.
Reckon Priceline Express deals can get you a great deal wherever you mosey.
You reckon? We reckon.
I reckon our work here is done. Vamanos!
Express deals. Priceline savings without the bidding.
Think he's happy?
Ooh, I reckon.
Tom O'Halloran, holding the line against tyranny from Washington, D.C.
I am America, one voice, united we stand. I am America, one hope to heal our land. There is still work that must be done.
And we are back. This is the Wednesday morning edition of the Patriot Radio Show. We're on the air with a good friend, Ken Crow. So, Ken, without Ohio, the road got a little tougher for Donald Trump, didn't it?
Not really. He's only got to get 40. He's still at 40%.
Yeah,
because he increased his lead last night by over 250 delegates.
But doesn't he need like 65% of all remaining delegates?
No, 40.
Oh, really? Okay.
Yeah. Cruz needs close to 90. Yeah. You see, a lot of these states coming up, like Utah, is proportional.
Yeah.
New Jersey's winner take all, but some of the others are proportional as well. And New Jersey, he'll take that. That's 51 delegates because Christie's beside him, and you know they got their love fest going on. So he'll take New Jersey. I personally see him taking Pennsylvania. Now, one thing, okay, Kathy said 60% this morning. That may be true. Well, I saw 40.
Yeah, I heard.
That could be yesterday.
I saw 65 over on Breitbart, which kind of caused me a little concern. I mean, Rubio threw all of his people behind Ted Cruz last night. So.
Well, sure, you got that Senate brotherhood thing going on.
Yeah.
But I don't think it's going to help. And here's why, guys, because what is the underlying theme? How did Donald Trump get to this point? You got to stop and think about that for a minute. How did he get to this point? He had zero political establishment anywhere on the ground for him nationwide.
Right.
He had none, okay? The one thing he did have, and I said this early on, and you'll remember our conversations from 4, 5, 6 months ago, I said the one thing that he's got that nobody else has is 100% name recognition. Hillary's the only other one that had 100% name recognition. And Kathy just made a good point, and I'm going to touch on that in just a minute, Kathy. But what he did was he had his finger on the pulse of the American people. He knew, and he said to himself, I'm presuming, you know, while he's sitting in the bathtub one morning, and he says to himself, you know, I believe I can pull this off because I know what is pushing America's buttons, and I know how angry they are, and I know how viciously angry they are. I don't know any other way to put it. The American people have had enough, and they want a revolution. And he said, you know what? I'm going to give them that revolution.
Yeah.
Because if we don't do this now, somewhere down the road, it's going to be a real revolution, and then it's going to be really, really ugly. Because our government is so corrupted, you know, and I'm sure he had some vested interest in there. I'm pretty sure he's been trying to do some business in China and various places and was trying to navigate all the red tape and all the crap with doing, you know. And he just finally said, yeah, I've had enough of this. It's got to change. It's killing our country. It's killing me. And I'm going to do something about it. And I'm pretty sure that's why he decided to do what he's done. But the bottom line is, he's a master at manipulating the media. He had the media standing on their heads for 6 months.
Sure.
There was somebody that put a pencil to it. Yesterday I saw on Fox News, and I don't remember who it was, but it was one of their experts, put a pencil to this. He has managed to obtain over $400 million in free media coverage. You know, everybody else is giving 15-minute, you know, oh, thank you, I want to thank the people of, you know, Alabama, whatever, whatever, whatever.
Yeah.
He gets an hour. He's doing a news conference, and they cover it for a solid hour.
Yep.
No advertising, no interruptions, no anything. And everybody else gets their 15 minutes, and Trump gets an hour.
Yeah.
You know, and this has been going on for month after month after month. And yeah, I don't blame the Cruz people for being angry, but it wouldn't matter because Cruz is not, I hate to say not newsworthy, but he's not Donald Trump.
Yeah.
Yeah. You know, it's like watching a NASCAR race. Why do we watch NASCAR races? We don't really watch them to watch the guys go fast, turn left, go fast, turn left.
We watch them
so we can see the wrecks.
Right.
We want to see the cars fly.
That's Donald Trump.
Don't want to get hurt.
That's Donald Trump. Our train wreck.
Yes. Everybody's waiting, and the media's waiting for the Trump to make the next train wreck happen. And it's newsworthy, so they've got to cover it. Yeah, he's a master at this.
Yeah.
And I'm sure that some of these train wrecks along the way, we think they're train wrecks. Trump's sitting up there laughing because it's all staged. You know,
sure. Well, I mean, how many times in the last 6 months have you heard, well, this is going to be the straw that broke Donald Trump's back?
Yeah, yep. Exactly.
This is going to be the one that does him in. His campaign is over as of that comment.
Look, I got to give accolades to Kathy Accordino. There's several times that I called her up months ago and I said, oh my God, what is this idiot doing? You know, and I'm screaming in her ear and on the telephone and just, you know, I cannot believe this moron just said this. And she's sitting there laughing. And what are you laughing about, Kathy? You don't get it, Ken. You don't get it. This is all pre-planned. He knows exactly what he's doing.
Yep.
And you and I are talking on the phone. God, I cannot believe he just said that about her. Oh, no, it's okay. Watch this. And she would tell me. And lo and behold, 2 days later, he went up 9 points in the polling.
Yeah.
And I'm sitting there going, how in God's name is this happening? You know, this is not right.
Yeah, it doesn't matter. I mean, and it's not just a comment. It's like, who would vote for that face? Then it was. I could go on the middle of Fifth Avenue and shoot someone, and I wouldn't lose any voters. It's like, you said what?
And she's bleeding from every orifice. And oh God, what a pig! You know.
And yet he gets a bump after every one of them too.
Yeah, it's like what's he gonna do next? You know. Well, the gloves are off now, and. Excuse me. I have no doubt that he's going to go after Cruz in a very vicious manner. You know, I want to also say this publicly. I thank Marco Rubio for what he did last night. It's not for, you know, he ran a decent campaign. He tried.
Yeah.
And he did his best. But what he showed last night was so much character.
Yep.
Because he could have stayed in this another week and, you know, caused a little more mischief and things like that, or 2 weeks or 3 weeks. But he didn't do it. And
yeah, a little humility.
He said, you know what, I'm going to step aside and go lick my wounds, get me a Fox gig, being a, you know, contributor. Yeah. And I'll hang out for a little while and maybe get picked up on somebody's ticket or pointed to something, or, you know, I'll come back and run again in 2 years for Senate seat or something. But he took a lot of character and it took a lot of courage, and he was a epitome of a gentleman last night.
Yep, a little humility goes a long way.
What Kasich is doing is nothing short of political treason to me. I mean, this guy is just, this is not right. It is not right at all.
He's got no possible way to win, so he's only doing it to throw the...
He could win every delegate left. It's not enough.
Yeah. Yep, they say he'd need like 120% of all the delegates left.
Sure. Apologize, I'm getting over my infection I've got. Long story short, June 7th is the next really big day. And June 7th is going to pretty well determine where we're at, who's going to win this. If there's going to be a winner, June 7th will be it. Now, somebody asked me this morning, matter of fact, maybe it was Kathy this morning, asked me about... I chatted with her for a couple of minutes, asked me about Arizona. Trump has done several events in Arizona. His last event out there, he sold out the the Phoenix or Arizona, the basketball team,
the Suns.
He filled up their stadium there, which was 25,000 odd people or something. Cruz hasn't had any major events out there, but what Arizona does have is a very large Tea Party contingent. And I'm going to make some phone calls out there today to my friends who are some leaders in the Tea Parties out there, and I'm going to sort of stick my finger in the wind and see which way the winds are blowing. But I'm thinking that Trump will take Arizona. I'm also pretty certain he'll take Utah, because Utah is sort of a while we believe in God, we want to be left alone about it type place.
Yeah.
And they're not going to appreciate Cruz's brand of Christianity in Utah.
You think?
And Utah is extremely conservative.
Yeah,
Kasich won't fly in Utah.
Yeah, they're not against Cruz because of the man and a woman being marriage. It's the one man and one woman that gets them.
Oh my God! I just saw who checked in.
Yeah, finally.
The chat room.
Finally,
Miss. No, I'm talking about Miss Alice Linehan. Do you know who Alice Linehan is?
No, she's been in a couple of times lately.
She is a major league power broker. She is in charge of one of the nation's leading activists, I guess you would call her, against Common Core.
Oh, God bless her.
And she's an expert on the subject. She's got a huge social media contingent. She built this army. I got to talk about her for a minute, because this lady, not only is she a beautiful, typical Texan lady, cowgirl type.
Well, she's a Texan, and anti-Common Core will have to have her on the show. What am I doing with you on the show?
Exactly. Well, she's also complete with the tight jeans and the cowboy hat. She's one of those Texas gals that everybody loves to smile at, tip their hat to. Anyway, she's a sweetie pie, brilliant, smart lady, has a huge social media following, and what she did was built an army. And when they want to go after somebody, she like pushes the button and has thousands of these people tweeting simultaneously and posting. And she gets it done. She's appeared in front of many, many state legislatures when they're in session, and she addresses the legislatures about Common Core and things like that. So she's a great lady, and she's on our side, and I'm a big Alice Linehan fan. You can good tell. I've known her for some time now, and she's a wonderful person.
Well, I'm a big fan as well. I'm very, very anti-Common Core, and hadn't come across her name before, but there's certainly a mic here for her when she's interested in coming on and getting her word out. So let's see. Let's do this. Let's pay some more bills. And when we come back, we're going to talk about June. Because a lot of things are going to happen between now and
June. I've got it pulled up. Got it pulled up. I'm armed and ready.
All right, brother. Folks, stick around. This is the Patriot Radio Show with Tom O'Halloran and our good friend Ken Crow. Stick around. We'll be right back.
It's that time again. It's what you've been dreading all year. It can be confusing, difficult, even painful. It has driven countless people to worry and to despair. It's something you hate, but something you have to do. It gets under your skin, and it can get you in over your head. It is income taxes. Now it is easier. It is faster. It can make you happy. It is less expensive than H&R Block and TurboTax. It will get you your biggest refund faster. It starts free.
It is eFile.com. eFile.com. We make income taxes fast and easy.
How's it going, JR fans? Nick Libretti here, and today we're smoking the Oliva Cane Daytona. Another home run from the Oliva company. Guys, this is the Cane Daytona. Medium to full body Nicaraguan smoke. Habano wrapper on it. Burns really, really nice. Hints of coffee. Really, really creamy. Flavorful smoke. This thing changes flavors on me 4 or 5 times throughout the cigar. It's excellent. 3 words I would use to describe this thing. Impeccable, complex, and out of this world. That's more than 3 words. Stop counting. We have 3 sizes, everything from a 46 to a 60 ring gauge. Get them right now at jrcigars.com.
Hi there, my name is Mark Kranenberg, and welcome to my kitchen. Today we're going to talk about my favorite order from Chicago Steak Company. It's the classic crime assortment. All right, well, let's open up and have a look what's inside. So right away, we've got 2 6-ounce filet mignons. If you know anything about steak, it's really rare to see filet mignons with that kind of marbling in it. Just beautiful steak. And then next, we've got the 2 12-ounce USDA prime strip steaks. Just look at how thick these things are. They're just beautiful. Again, beautifully marbled, amazing steak. Then we've got 2 USDA prime ribeyes. And if you like steak that is just mouth-watering, this is the steak for you. With all that marbling inside, you'll see it's thicker. The marbling is a lot thicker. That just means more moisture throughout your steak. Now we've got 6 USDA prime top sirloin steaks. These are the steaks that everyone's gonna love. Then we're moving into our next package. Next, we have 16 4-ounce gourmet Angus steak burgers. These are amazing burgers that everyone's gonna love. And to top it all off, they give you 1 container of my favorite steak seasoning of all time, the Chicago Steak Spice, and you're gonna love it too. So there you have the classic prime assortment, my favorite and your ultimate steak experience. So be sure to order your steak today at mychicagosteak.com. I'm Mark. Don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel, like us on Facebook, follow us on Twitter, and we'll see you next time at mychicagosteak.com.
Tom O'Halloran.
We'll put a boot in your ass. It's the American way. All brought to you courtesy of the red, white, and blue. Oh, of my red, white, and blue.
And we are back. This is the Wednesday morning edition of the Patriot Radio Show, a special post-primary edition. We're on the phone with our good friend Ken Crow, political guru, author of the upcoming book Ego in a Teabag. Watch for it on Amazon come June. And visit his website, crowsnestpolitics.com. Are you still there, brother?
We're hanging tough, Tom.
So Trump won 4 out of the 5 states, lost Ohio by a bigger margin than I even dreamt he might, but we're still head and shoulders above the rest of the pack, though.
Well, I fully expected him to lose Ohio. I
know you called
him to win, but you know, okay, so he loses by 3 or 4 points to Kasich based upon the Republican vote, and then you throw him a couple of more points that he lost by because of the Democrats. I don't have a problem with that. He did well. He represented well. And given the choice between Democrat or Trump, Ohio will select Trump.
Yeah.
I have no doubt about that. I'm not concerned about that. I think as I think he'll do the same thing in Pennsylvania. On June 7th is going to be another huge day because we have New Jersey, which is 50-something delegates, and I believe it's, I'm almost certain it's winner-take-all, too. And then we've got California. And California's 155 delegates. I'm not quite sure how they proportion them out there. And the big question is up in the air now is, can Trump take California because of Kasich being in the race? We know Cruz won't be a factor in California. On the surface, you'd think, well, yeah, he's Hispanic, and California's, you know, largely Hispanic today.
Yeah.
But they're all Democrats. So
yeah, not likely to be his state. I believe California does it by district, but I won't swear to it.
You know, I have to look that up. I'm not certain. But long story short, I think Trump wins California. I really do. I don't think. Now, here's the thing. I've got a problem with Trump right now. And I was chatting with Kathy about this a little bit earlier. And I'm going to put out some tweets today. I may tweet one of them at you, and if you're still messing around Twitter at all. But I think it's time Trump break the checkbook out. You know, these states that he's lost, and he poured $1 million or $2 million into them, he could have won them.
Yeah.
But he didn't.
It's time to open the wallet.
I think he needs to break the checkbook out. It's time, you know, the days of cheap campaigning's over with. I think he needs to say, okay, you know, I set aside $200 million for marketing. I think I need, you know, start spending 30 or 40 of that.
Yeah.
And I think he needs to because these states are starting to get a little bit closer, and they'll continue to be close, and he needs to expose Cruz for what he actually is.
Sure.
And Cruz is not... The, you know, Cruz is a constitutional conservative. So is Trump. Trump is not out there trying to, you know, I don't like cops. I don't like that Second Amendment thing. I think I'll get away to change it. Yeah, he's not trying to do that. He's ever been as constitutional as you and I are. Maybe, you know, maybe more so. I don't know. But, you know, it's like I said in my article this morning about that. At Crow's Nest, I said, you know, everybody's touting Cruz as this wonderful constitutional conservative, but that's what he went to college for. The guy specialized in the Constitution in law school.
Yeah.
That's what he did. And he became a prosecutor, and all that.
Yeah.
And a solicitor. And that was his job. Nobody expects the president to be a constitutional expert. That's why we have a White House legal team. That's why they have lawyers in the White House. Every time they want to do something, the president will call in the lawyers, or the chief of staff will, and they'll have a meeting and say, is this legal? What are we doing here? Are we going to face any kind of legal crisis if we do this? And the lawyers say yes or no. That's what they're there for. They're there to protect the presidency from breaking constitutional law.
Yep.
So it's ludicrous to think, well, we can only have a president that's a constitutional scholar. We saw how well that worked the last 7 years, didn't we?
Got that right. Got that right.
I'm not worried about it. You know, they got a dozen lawyers in that White House.
Yeah.
That work directly for that president.
Nope, you're right. Being a constitutionalist is much more important for a senator or a congressman than it is for a president.
Well, the president is not going to do something that's unconstitutional.
Hello?
Because
hello?
The minute,
Hello?
Well, yeah, normally.
Hello?
Because
where you been, son?
The lawyers run in the offices and say, "Sir, Mr. Reagan, you can't do this."
Yeah.
Oh, okay. You know, Mr. Bush, no, you can't do this. Oh, okay, I get it. You know, they know what they're doing.
Yeah.
And they're not, you know, it isn't going to happen. It's like everybody's worried about Trump pushing the red button. You got to get through several generals and a bunch of other people before you ever get your hand on that red button. You can't just go, "Oh, Vladimir, watch this and push that, the button."
That's right.
No.
Yeah.
It doesn't work that way.
While you're on the phone with them.
Yeah, it doesn't work that way. So, people panic for no reason. And these guys know what they're doing. They're not stupid. And so I think in the end, Trump's going to win California. I think he wins New Jersey. So that'll put him up. He'll pick up, you know, 75 or 80 out of California. That'll put him at right at 900 right there between those two states alone. And then we've still got, don't we still have Virginia?
Yep, Virginia's still on the table.
That's another big one as well.
But that ought to fall
real... Virginia's got a lot of delegates.
That ought to fall real easily along with Pennsylvania for Trump, shouldn't it? I mean, they're both right there in that same corridor.
Well, see, Pennsylvania is next door to Ohio.
Right, but Trump won the eastern counties, all the eastern counties along the border of Pennsylvania. He won those.
Okay,
every one of them.
See the map.
Yep.
Okay, very good. Very good.
It's like two counties in, all the way down the border. So he got that border, and he got the southern border as well.
Perfect.
So yeah, it was pretty nice, and I thought it was a foretell of what's going to happen in Pennsylvania when I saw that. So I think Pennsylvania is an easy one, and because of that, Virginia. So,
well, Trump will win Maine. He'll win. He'll win all of those northeastern states remaining.
Yeah, New York.
I cannot see Cruz winning Washington. Washington's just too liberal. If Kasich's still around, Kasich could possibly do well. Kathy's fear is Wisconsin. And Scott Walker is pretty popular, very popular with the Republicans in Washington or in Wisconsin. It's all going to depend on if Walker's going to come out and endorse anybody.
Yeah.
If Walker endorses Cruz, Cruz could possibly do well. But Walker doesn't appear to me to be quite that far right as Cruz is. Kasich is pretty moderate, and Kasich also is a grouchy old man, which doesn't fit with... I could actually see Walker, but Walker may try to... I'm thinking out loud here. Walker may try to retain his political standing, and he may be forced into... If he may just abdicate and say, "No, I'm not going to endorse anybody. I'll let it play out," which I hope he does.
Yeah.
But if he's forced into actually endorsing somebody, that could actually be detrimental for him. So I'm not certain that he's going to be willing to do that. I hope he doesn't.
Yeah.
Paul Ryan has already said he's not going to endorse anybody.
Really?
He's going to let it. Yeah, he's going to let it because he's technically the leader of the party right now.
Well, I figured he'd endorse somebody from the party, one of the remaining two.
He's the chairman of the convention.
Yeah.
So
okay.
He's not going to get into that snake pit.
Yeah.
And the reason I bring him up is because he's from Wisconsin.
He's a chairman of the convention, and he's already talking about throwing his hat in the ring at the convention.
Yeah.
What a scumbag.
Yeah, he is. Well, I don't know. You know, it. Look, if you're Paul Ryan, think about it for a minute. If you're Paul Ryan, and you see this thing coming, this huge train wreck coming at the convention, and it's like, oh my God, you're going to have to offer the constituency some outs. You're going to have to do that. And then that's why the presumptive, when you go to a broker convention, more often than not, does not win. Because you get these two forces competing so heavily against each other that there is no winner. It's like taking two bull elephants and having them, you know, butt heads.
Yep.
Who's going to move who? You know, they both weigh 6,000 pounds. Who's going to move who?
Well,
what you get into. And he may very well be thinking, this is my one chance to become president.
Yeah, I'm of a mindset, if you want to be the president, run to be the president. Let the people elect you. You don't go into
this little back room. It is going through the constitutional process that we have.
That's not constitutional. That's going through the party politics games.
Well, no, because you have your delegates. Your delegates are part of the representative republic representation. They are representing the people back home at the convention for the party.
But they're not. And they're not, because the party rules let them vote their own way. If they were representative of the people back home, they would be bound to vote the way the people told them to vote. But
they are the first ballot.
As of today, yeah. But you and I both know that they're working on changing that.
Well, let's not speculate for a minute. Let's assume that it goes the way it's historically supposed to go, okay? Right. And they vote the first ballot. There is no resolution. Trump showed up with 1,124 delegates. He was, you know, 100 delegates short. He did his best. And so we have a vote. Those 1,124 vote for Trump. Nobody else moves. Now we got a war. Now what do you do? If you're Paul Ryan, what do you do? Seriously, think about it, man. The Cruz people ain't moving. The Trump people aren't moving so far.
Right.
What do you do? You've got to come up with a nominee. And the American people have said through the county election process, I could have been a delegate. All I had to do was go to the meeting after my caucus, sit in a little room, give my one-minute speech on why I think I'd be a good delegate. There were like 25 people in the room. They elected, I think, 18 delegates or something to go to the state convention. So we go to the state convention, and we have those meetings, and we elect our, what do we get? I don't know, 48 delegates or something. So I had a pretty good chance of becoming a delegate if I wanted to be, because I have enough friends. excuse me. I have enough friends down at the state where I probably could have been elected as a delegate.
Yeah.
And so what am I doing now? I'm representing my people in my state that are Republicans to the national process for nominating our candidate for president. We've got these two huge bulls butting heads. Nobody's giving an inch. You've got to offer an alternative. And this is where Mitt Romney's probably going to step in. Paul Ryan's going to step in, and you may see a couple more out of left field jump in.
Think Rubio's still trying? Or you think he's...
I think Rubio is going to hang around, pray like hell. It's a possibility, but I actually think Rubio would probably put his name in the hat for a VP slot.
Yeah. Yeah, it's, he sounded pretty much resigned to it not being his time last night.
Yeah. And see, that's telling the party. He's sending a message to the party by saying that, too. Hey, look, I'm on your side. I'm a company man. I'll follow company protocol.
Yeah.
And that's what he's doing. I'm here to follow company protocol. Please reward me. That's exactly what that was. Yeah. I'm going to step aside. I'm going to, you know, let the big boys play. But please reward me in the end.
Yeah.
And that's exactly what they're doing.
I'm going to wait my turn now. Now that trying to jump the gun didn't work. I'll follow your rules.
Yes, I know, Kathy. I'm going to go to the doctor and get antibiotics. Well, I personally think if you have Paul Ryan jump in there, you know, from a political point of view, I'm a Trump fan. But if they have, if the party has decided, you know, are we willing to give up the country to Hillary? That's the question you got to ask yourself.
Well, that's a scary thought if they're willing to do that.
Well, because that, but it's a very valid question.
Yeah.
And you've got to ask that question because if we stand back and our people, I say our people, I'm talking about grassroots, but, you know, Alice is smarter than this, so I'm not worried about her. But if you now she is, seriously. You're not going to take the Tea Party. What I am concerned about is the Tea Party and the grassroots. If they don't get their way, they stay home.
Yeah.
And I've got a real problem with that, folks. You know, hey, look, you didn't get your way this time. Suck it up. Vote for one of our own, and we'll try it again next time. Don't give the country to Hillary. We cannot afford it. Well, there's no difference. Well, yeah, there's a big difference between Paul Ryan and Hillary Clinton. Give me a break.
But hold on. You're laying this on the Tea Party. If Trump gets the 1237 and he is the nominee, you're going to have large swaths of the GOP regulars. They're going to stay home and hand the country.
No. The GOP regulars will support Trump because in the end, Trump's policies are not as hard right, and while his rhetoric is abrasive, it's not politically abrasive. He's not using right-wing scare tactics like Cruz is. Am I making sense? Yeah, are you not? Trump's rhetoric is, last night he stood up and goes, when he insulted the reporters, you know.
Yeah.
He's having a little fun. He's picking on the reporters. He's insulting them.
I love that. They give him all this free airtime, and he always stands up there and says, you guys are a bunch of criminals. You're not worth a spit on the sidewalk.
Exactly. So he's spewing fun rhetoric. He's not spewing hardcore right-wing political rhetoric.
Yeah.
Because in a lot of respects, he is a moderate in some respects. And that's okay, because that's what's appealing to the Democrats and the middle of the road. You know, remember, all these people want change, too. They're sick of this. The conservative Democrats have had enough. They've had enough of the Pelosi's and the Clintons and Hillary Clinton. And the Obamas. They've had enough of it.
Yeah.
They want this country to come back to the middle. And Alice just brought up a huge point that Cruz just brought in Neil Bush, which is a huge fundraiser for the Bush camp and the Republican Party. And, yeah, that's a big deal. So that's another proof of the pudding. That Cruz is not the, you know, what his followers think he is.
Exactly.
He's done a masterful art at putting a veil over that. He really has. I mean, he sold himself as a... And I often wondered why, and Alice knows Katrina, I've often wondered why Katrina jumped ship and left Cruz and went to Trump. Now I know.
Well, a lot of reasons. Now we talked about that when it happened. Number one, she wanted to be on a winning ship. Two, she knew the real Cruz. She knew who he really was by now.
Oh, yeah. Well, she knew going in. I mean, she knew after he was elected from the last campaign in Texas.
Yeah.
She figured it out. And she was willing to stick with him for a while, you know, but apparently he never changed or did something to hack her off. But at any rate, because she was instrumental in getting him elected in Texas. She played a role.
Oh, yeah.
She was one that brought the Tea Parties to his side.
Very much so. Brother, any final thoughts?
It was a great night. It was a great night last night. Tell your friends. Settle them down. Read that article I wrote today at Crow's Nest. It's the latest one I put up. Because I list the 10 reasons in there to not fear Trump. He is conservative. He is going to be okay. And these are 10 factual reasons. And go to your Cruz people, share it with them, and say, stop panicking, guys, really. He's not the Antichrist that you seem to think he is. He's actually a pretty damn good guy. And, yeah, he can be a little abrasive. He's not as polished as we're used to for a president. And that's okay. You know, neither was Teddy Roosevelt. He wasn't polished. Neither was Harry Truman. We've heard all those stories about Harry Truman. They didn't got him on tape. You know, Harry Truman was about as abrasive as it gets.
Yeah.
So he was a great president. So don't panic. Get out there and support Trump, and let's make sure he gets his 1237. Then we can hang it on the Republicans' head and threaten them with mutiny.
Exactly. Whether the next round of primaries, do we have anything happening?
Next Tuesday, we have Utah and Arizona. Then the week after that, we have three or four more.
Nothing over the week. Nothing over the weekend then.
No, okay. No, not that I know of.
I hadn't checked the calendar for a little bit. All right, brother.
All right. Alice put up a video, I guess. I'll have to go watch that.
She put up a few. Scroll back up. There's a bunch of good links there opened up between her and Kathy. So a lot of good stuff come through the chat room. I want to thank everybody in the chat room today. Kathy, Charlie Cook, Carla Presley, Alice Linehan, thank you for coming in. Liesl Gretz and Kathy, are you there twice? No. And Catherine from Midland. Thank you all. I love having you guys in. You're a very, very important part of the show. God bless each and every one of you. Richard, where are you at today? You are absent without excuse. Folks, this is the post Super Tuesday show. Ken, thank you, brother. God bless you for taking the time to be with us today.
You're very welcome, my friend, and I guess we'll see you soon.
We'll see you soon. We'll talk to you Monday morning, if not sooner.
Okay, my friend. See you then.
Hi,
God
brother.
Bless.
God bless you as well.
Love you, Alice. Bye-bye, darling.
Folks, that is Ken Crow. See his CrowsNestPolitics.com, getting over 100,000 hits a day now. It's a big thing. If you haven't been going there, make sure you do. Watch for his upcoming book, Ego in a Teabag, coming to Amazon by June. God bless you and yours, America. This is Tom O'Halloran. I'm out.